hey, this is DJ Disciple, and you're looking at some of the excerpts from where I've been traveling for the last 15 years. I've been playing in London for the longest amount of time and been recognized for my efforts in creating, helping to create a scene down here. Back in the early 90s in New York, I wasn't really embraced outside of my radio station. But when I came to London, I absorbed the sound and the music industry. What I started doing is I played for two different scenes in London. I played for the northern scene, which was like Hard Times, Up Your Ronson, Love to Be, and Newcastle's, To the Manor Born, and Southport Weekender. I was doing clubs like The Empire, and I was playing at those kind of clubs. But then I would play at London clubs like Paul Trouble Anderson's, The Loft, Camden Palace. I would play at underground parties like The Velvet and Garage City. And Bobby and Steve helped break my name on the soulful house scene. So I've always played two different scenes. One was more trendy and one was more traditional. The trendy scene was like the Northern Soul, Funky House, harder side. And then the traditional was soulful, more Americanized and more recognized, like more tastier, more quality side of the music. And I always had that kind of following where I always played traditional styles and I played trend. I've never been one to really be in a box, so I've always kind of spread out in different styles. Work It Out is a trendy arrival for me, but it's not so much of a soulful departure. I will always love soulful music, but I will always stay with the trends, because that's what the challenge is of being an artist is not to just stay in one genre of music, but to challenge myself to be in different genres and to excel in whatever my support system is for that moment. And my support system has really appreciated the fact that I've been able to branch out and try different things instead of staying in the same mold. So that's what kind of benefited me in what I was able to do. I've survived, you know? And in that survival, you know, I haven't taken it as a notch of a way to say, you know what, I'm this good. I've taken it in a way to say, like, you know what, I can do it and so can you. So I've given somebody else some inspiration, like the way I've seen in England. That's one of the great things that I learned about England and love about England is that there was other DJs that inspire each other to do things that can make their scene grow. And in America, sometimes that didn't happen. You know, a lot of times the DJs would just be for themselves. They would do for themselves. They'd do their own parties. Or they wasn't inclusive. They wasn't as inviting as the culture that I saw in England. And I'm happy to be a part of this culture because I see how the promoters really get together, how they really promote their events. You know, if you made it big here, you made it big everywhere. If you was a big DJ here, it kind of set the message that you was big everywhere. You could get work everywhere. And, you know, that said something to me early on. And so I based my press around that. And then what happened was, when I was getting a lot of work over here, the American promoters started picking up. So I was starting to play at places like Dallas. I was playing at places like Seattle and San Francisco and all these places. And they was thinking of me like as a, you know, this guy from the UK that can play all these UK and rock all these UK clubs. As a matter of fact, my residency was based on what I did in my Ministry of Sound stint and playing in the UK so much. There was a party called GBH, Great British House. And that party started because they wanted to cater to more of a British audience. And they knew that I played in England a lot and I was a more commercial name. So they used my name to market their party, to help market their party, because they knew I played at places like Ministry of Sound and Gatecrasher and so forth. So they said, you know what? we want to use you as our DJ. So I started playing more of the UK sound in New York and drawing more of a UK audience. And that turned around, and that was a big plus for me in the end. It was really, really good for me, because what that wound up doing is it started opening up my audience and my fan base to know that I was just more than just a traditional DJ, that I became this DJ that became trendy and for that moment. And then I just lasted more than just that moment, you know? So I contributed to the scene as much as I could to give what I had, because I got into the music because I wanted to leave a legacy. I wanted to be able to explore all the avenues of dance music and be able to be happy with it in the end, to be able to know that I've been able to leave something behind and to know that I've been able to continue to do the right thing. And that's what it's about for me. And, you know, hopefully things will go the way that I expect them to go. I know they will, because, you know, I've left, you know, my music in the hearts of many of people that I won't ever be forgotten. So that's where I'm at right now, and that's where I'm happy to be.